Hey guys, what's up? Jeremy Schaefer here. Well, Halloween's less than a week away, so check out the new model that I just designed for this week. It's a haunted house pop-up card. There's the house, and it opens up into two ghosts that are dancing in front of a gravestone. Isn't that cool? Want to learn how to fold it? Ready, set, here goes. So for this model, I used a 10-inch square of Kami, and that's what I recommend using. I mean, you could use a 6-inch square, but this is a rather complex model, so I'd recommend using a 10-inch square. So let's begin white side up, and let's fold in half. Make sure to make really precise folds and crease sharply. This is an advanced model, so if you're new to folding, I don't recommend holding this, but if you're up for the challenge, then let's continue. Let's rotate and let's fold the front edge to the top. Make very precise folds. Now let's bring this flap up and let's rotate. And now let's fold in half in this direction. And unfold, and let's fold this flap to the crease. Make sure to go exactly to the crease. And rotate, and let's fold this flap to here. Make sure the edges touch perfectly, and crease sharply. Okay, let's rotate, and let's fold this edge to here. And rotate. And now let's fold these two flaps up. I'm going to do them individually. And this side. Okay, now holding here, right here, let's slide this flap out and bring it up. Now holding down here, let's pull this flap out and bring it up. Okay, now let's open this pocket, put your finger inside, and let's squash this flap so this crease aligns with this edge. Make sure it comes right to the point and flatten. And let's repeat on this side. Okay, now let's rotate, and let's fold this flap up so that this corner goes to here. And let's repeat on this side. Okay, let's rotate. And now let's fold this flap up to this edge, but we're just going to make a little crease mark right in the middle. There. and unfold. And now let's fold this edge to the crease mark. And once again, let's just make a little crease mark right there and unfold. And one last time, let's fold up to the crease mark and make a little crease mark and unfold. And let's rotate. And now let's fold this flap up to this point right here, the intersection of the creases. And crease sharply. And now let's repeat on this side. And let's unfold both flaps. Okay, now we're going to sink these two flaps on the two creases that we just made. So let's start with this one. Let's unfold like this. And here are the creases that we're going to sink on. So get out your pinchers. And let's pinch along all three creases. Make sure to have your other hand behind to provide support. And here. Okay, so we've pinched all three creases. And now let's push the middle point in and let's bring these two edges together. And let's bring these two edges together and these edges together and flatten it like this. So there we sunk the flap. Let's repeat on this side. And I'm going to do it a little bit quicker. Okay, let's rotate. And now let's fold this flap to the nearest crease. And just fold from here to there. And unfold. And now let's fold this flap up right on this line. And unfold. And now we're going to reverse fold it into this slot. So just push it in on the existing creases and flatten. And let's repeat on this side. And unfold and reverse it. Okay, now let's fold this flap up. And let's fold this flap up. Now let's rotate, and now we're going to fold this interior flap, and the fold should go from this point inside the pocket, and it should terminate at this point. So looking in, it's like that. And let's repeat on this side. Okay, now let's rotate. And these are going to become the two ghosts. We're gonna let them hide up there. Let's work on the house. So let's fold this flap to this point. And unfold and open the pocket. And let's stick it inside. Make sure it goes all the way to the bottom of the pocket and close it. Okay, now let's fold this flap down to this point and let's fold this flap up to this point. This side of the house is going to have a chimney, so that's what we're making right now. Okay, now let's fold this flap up. How far? Well, this is kind of tricky. We're going to fold it up so that this length is equal to this length. So just do your best to estimate that. And you can see how accurate you were on this next step. Let's fold this edge to here. And if you made that fold correctly, then this edge should terminate right on this edge. Okay, now let's unfold this flap and let's fold this little flap over so that the two edges align. And now let's unfold both flaps and let's unfold this flap and open the big pocket and let's fold the corner inside right on the crease like that and close the pocket and let's fold it down again and over again and now we're going to reverse fold this corner right on this crease so it's like that and flatten and open it. And now we're going to reverse fold it again on the two diagonal creases. So fold this edge down, fold these two edges together, and flatten it. So here we have the chimney flap. Now all we have to do is fold it up so that it sticks out of the roof. So we're folding it right on that point. And we want this edge to be parallel with the side of the house. So it sticks straight up. Okay, now let's fold this flap over. And let's fold this flap over. And let's turn over and rotate. And now let's fold this corner to right here. And we're just going to make a little crease mark. You can let the roof swing out. So we're just going to make a crease mark right there and unfold. And now let's fold this edge to the crease mark and let the roof swing down. And this time, fold all the way across. Try to keep the fold even. So we just made a pleat right there. Close it back up. And let's repeat on this side. So fold this corner to there. And unfold it and fold this edge to that crease mark, letting the roof swing down. And fold it all the way across. So it's like that. Okay, now let's reverse fold this itsy bitsy flap. If you want, you can first fold it over and unfold it, and now just push it in and close it. So there's the reverse fold. Let's repeat on this side. And close it. Let's turn over. And now let's fold this flap up. So it's like that. Let's turn over. And let's reverse fold this little itsy bitsy flap. And yeah, you could fold it over. Or you could just go straight in and reverse it. Okay, and let's repeat on this one. And I'm just going to reverse it without pre-creasing it. So it's like that. Now let's fold this raw edge inside. So this flap, this interior flap, gets folded inside right there, and it goes all the way across, and it meets up with this flap. Just fold this flap inside like that. Okay, so that's what the house looks like from this side. And it kind of looks like Pikachu. Okay, let's turn over and let's fold this raw edge inside. So we're just pushing it in like that. And it's going to slant upward, the fold. So it gets narrower and narrower, and it meets up with this point. Like that. From inside, looks like that. Let's repeat on this side. Okay, the house is done. Let's work on the ghosts. Let's fold these flaps down like this. And let's fold this flap up like turning the page of a book. And same with this flap. And let's rotate. And now let's fold this raw corner up so that this edge aligns with this crease. And let's repeat on this side. And let's rotate. And let's fold this corner up to this edge right there on the crease. And let's repeat on this side. Okay, now let's unfold these two flaps and let's rabbit ear the flap. So let's fold this edge to the crease and we just need to fold right to there and unfold. And now let's fold this edge to the crease. And unfold. And now let's fold both of them together. So we're pinching the corner. And let's fold it to the right. And let's repeat on this side. And let's fold this one to the left. Okay, let's fold this flap up and repeat on this side and rotate. And now let's fold this front flap up so that this edge aligns with this edge. And let's repeat on this side. And now let's unfold this flap and unfold this flap. And now let's fold this flap over so that this edge aligns with the crease. And let's repeat on this side. Now let's rotate and let's fold both flaps up. Now let's reach in here and let's pull the rabbit ear flap out and squash it. So it's like that. And let's repeat on this side. So reach in, pull out the corner and flatten. All right, now we're going to hold like this and just slide the head, this is the head, up just a little bit so that when we flatten it, this comes to a point. We don't need to make it come to a perfect point. Let's make it come to a blunt point like this. This is the arm and we're just kind of narrowing it towards the hand. And let's do the same thing on this side. I kind of already did it, but anyway, you just want it to come to a blunt point and flatten. And let's repeat on this side. Okay, now let's fold this flap up so that this edge touches this point. Now let's fold it over so that the fold aligns with this edge. This is the hand. Okay, let's repeat on this side. All right, now let's bring the flaps down and rotate, and let's do the same thing here. So let's bring this flap up so that it touches the white point and fold it over so that the fold aligns with this edge. And let's repeat on this side. Okay, now let's fold this flap up so that this edge aligns with this crease. And now we're going to reverse fold this flap. So basically, just stuff it in right on the existing creases and flatten. So that's what it should look like. And you can see how the ghost is taking shape. Let's work on this ghost. This ghost is going to have a little bit of a different position. So let's bring it up like this and rotate. And let's fold this flap so that this edge aligns with this crease. And once again, let's reverse fold this point. Like that. And rotate. Okay, let's kind of pull these guys open a little bit so that they take shape. So that's the idea. Now all that's left to do is round them. So let's start with the head. If you want, you can make a little crimp here by just pushing the head down. This actually forms the shoulders. So it goes like this. And now let's open this pocket. And I'm gonna use the pencil. Okay, so it's like this. And there's the head. And you can kind of round that to taste. I like actually doing wrinkle folds, which is rubbing the paper back and forth. And in order to do that, you want to first lick your fingertips so that you have traction. So it's like this, and you just wrinkle it back and forth to loosen the paper, and it makes it nice and curvy, like that. And now I'm gonna wrinkle fold this side of the head. And see how round that is. And put the crimp back in. And there we have the head all done. Oh, except that let's take this little flap and curl it over. This is the hair of the ghost, like that. Okay, now let's wrinkle fold the elbow joints. So here goes. And you can kind of curl the hands to taste. And let's wrinkle fold this elbow joint. And curl the hand to taste. And stick the crimp back in. That's looking pretty good. Okay, now somehow try to curve these two folds, this one and this one. You can just kind of make a tiny wrinkle fold there, and they already look pretty curvy, but anyway. So it's like that. And just open the body. And there we have one ghost. Let's make the other ghost. And I'm going to fast forward this. All right, so there we have the two ghosts. And if you want, you can hide this little white part by just folding the edge up like that. And now all that's left to do is close the card. So let's fold this whole tombstone up, and we're going to make the fold start at this point and fold it down. The fold goes from this point and it slants down and ends right where this crease touches this edge, right there. And let's repeat on this side. So the fold goes from here and slants downwards and ends right there. So from this side, that's the fold that we made. And it just closes like that. And pops up. And a tip is that when you close this, you don't really want to flatten it, otherwise you'll ruin the shape of the ghost. So just kind of keep it 3D and then open it up, and the ghost will hopefully still be in shape. So just open them up a little bit like that. So just close them carefully. This ghost should be down here, and this one up here. And this ghost is kind of sticking out of the house. That's okay. And there we have it. Now, I don't know why you'd want to do this, but if you want to close the card and lock it, then you can take this flap and you can stick it into this pocket. So just stick it in like that. And that makes the chimney kind of stick out nicely. And There's the ghosts. Now, the ghosts are sticking out. If you want to perform this, then what you can do is you can just hold it like this so that your thumb and index finger block the view of the ghosts. Well, sort of, just kind of figure out how it blocks it like that. And then when you want to open it, you just undo the lock and then open it up like this. And you might need to open up the ghosts a little bit and just kind of shape them to taste. And there you have it. Next time, don't close it so much. Okay, like that, and ba-da! And then to make the ghosts dance, you just close and open the card a little bit, just push the sides together. And from the back side, there's the tombstone. And there are the ghosts dancing. So there you have it. Well, this was a pretty monumental tutorial. Hope you guys had some luck at that, or rather skill. And yeah, have a happy Halloween, or whatever other day of the year it is. Whoosh! Oh, ha, ha, ha. Ooh. Bye-bye.